everybody, and welcome to Worship Wednesday. This Worship Wednesday is for you specifically if you've ever had one of those really, really, really rough weeks and you just don't feel like worshiping. And sometimes it becomes this discipline where we have to force ourselves to really set aside time to worship. This was one of those weeks for me. Something really beautiful happened to me because as I was preparing for this and worshiping myself beforehand, I just began to feel the Holy Spirit, and I felt like God was speaking the language that I didn't have words for, and I was finally able to feel connected to Him. And sometimes I feel like we have to use that discipline in our faith to bring ourselves before God, and then God meets us there. And I really feel like He did that for me this week. And so I really want to share this moment with y'all, and I want to worship with y'all. And I hope that if it's been a rough week for you, that you can experience that too. And just know that no matter what's going on, sometimes we feel like we're worshiping in the middle of darkness, in the middle of a storm, but God is right there with you. And if you needed to hear that today, this Worship Wednesday is for you. This week, I am singing Hosanna. And the reason that this song stood out to me, because I always wondered, like, you know, what is the actual specific definition of Hosanna, and like, where did that come from? And as I was reading, I want to read something to y'all. Most likely, the authors of the Gospels transliterated Hosanna rather than translating it, because it served on the people's lips as a joyful exclamation, which, if translated, would have sounded like a prayer. In similar fashion, John transliterated Hallelujah in Revelation. It's almost like it was such a meaningful word that they had to translate it exactly how it was, because it became a prayer. It became more than just language. And it goes on to talk about how Hosanna is when they saw Jesus. They were exclaiming it from their lips because it means praise God and His Messiah. We are saved. And that whole entire phrase is that word. And I just think that is so beautiful. Lord, I just come to you in prayer, God, and I ask, Holy Spirit, that you would move and speak on our behalf, God, that you would speak utterances from our soul, Lord, that would just come to your ears, God, and that you would pray things on our behalf that we don't even understand or realize that we need, Lord. And I just pray that you would come, God, completely in your authentic form, Lord, in truth and in love, Lord. And I just pray that you would speak to our hearts, God, today. And I just thank you for Hosanna, God, that we get to say Hosanna, Lord, that we get to be praising your name, God, praising that you made a way for us to speak with you, Lord. You made a way for us to come to you and to feel your presence, Lord. And I'm just so thankful for that today, God. And I just pray for every single person that's watching this video, that you would also be right there with them. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. It is always my goal to be as authentic and truthful and real with y'all as I can. I think one of the things that can become a stumbling block for some of us Christians is people who act like they have it all together and who never show that they're real and that they struggle with things, and that some days you just don't feel it. Some days you're having a really, really rough day, but I just want to say that our human weakness, that doesn't stop God, and that doesn't stop His presence, and that doesn't stop Him from meeting with us and for Him being as powerful as He is. Yes, we have emotions that fluctuate every day, and throughout the day they fluctuate, but God doesn't change, and He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So always remember that. If you're ever having a rough day, or you're having a rough week or month or season, God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So when you're in those rough seasons, remember those times that God met you. Remember those times where you did have that sweet time with the Lord, because He is the same. He is just as there for you. Just sometimes we're going through stuff, or we have a rough day and our emotions are all out of whack and we just don't feel it. But that doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with you. That doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with God. God's not different. He is the same. So just when you're having those moments, take peace in that. Take peace in that God is still the same and He's still there for you. And I'm praying for y'all. I'm praying that y'all have a great week, that you have a great day. And thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you next week.